In this video today, we are going to be covering some tips to make sure that your messaging is in line with what your customers want. Also, how does your messaging relate to your competitors' messaging? And then also just some overarching big picture ideas all about, you guessed it, messaging. Messaging, messaging, messaging. Let's go. The first term to cover today is market sophistication. And this is a term made by someone named Eugene Schwartz. And this describes the level of awareness that your customers have about the various solutions available in your industry. And there are 5 levels. Okay, level 1. This is the birth of a market, a brand new market. There is literally no competition. At this stage, you can make pretty much any claim and people will buy it. So for each level, I'm gonna read the actual description from Eugene Schwartz just so that it is crystal clear for everybody. Level 1, be simple, be direct, above all, don't be fancy. Name either the need or the claim in your headline, nothing more. Dramatize the claim in your copy, make it as powerful as possible, and then bring in your product and prove that it works. So a relevant example right now for a level 1 market would be if you developed a cure to COVID-19. That would be a technological breakthrough, the birth of a market, and you could pretty much make any claim because this is something that people want. It didn't previously exist and people would want to buy it. So next up is level 2. So this really is very similar to level 1. It's just now there are competitors. So you just need to make a bigger claim. And this is the time when you'll often hear things like bigger, better, faster. So here's what Eugene Schwartz has to say about level 2. If you're second and the direct claim is still working, then copy that successful claim, but enlarge on it. Drive it to the absolute limit, outbid your competition. So a very popular example in a level 2 market is about weight loss. So you could say, my supplement helps you lose weight faster than my competitors. That's it. Okay, so now at level 3, you need to introduce a mechanism with a logical reason for why your claim is achievable. Your market is becoming more educated, and at this time you need to give them logic and reason for them to want to take action. So, as Eugene says, if your market is at the stage where they've heard all the claims in all of their extremes, then mere repetition or exaggeration won't work any longer. What this market needs now is a new device to make all these claims become fresh and believable to making them again. In other words, a new mechanism, a new way to making the old promise work. A different process, a fresh chance, a brand new possibility of success where only disappointment has resulted before. So now with level 3 market, we will go back to the weight loss example. So for example, with the introduction of intermittent fasting, this is a new mechanism that is a claim to help you actually lose weight again. Level 4 is to create a better mechanism than the previous version of your mechanism. So this is very similar as the jump from level 1 to 2. This is again a jump from level 3 to 4 of just taking the same mechanism but making it even stronger. So now there's even more competition in the market. So your message also needs to level up and match and become that much stronger. And in the words of Eugene Schwartz, if a competitor has just introduced a new mechanism to achieve the same claim as that performed by your product, and that new mechanism announcement is producing sales, then counter in this way. Simply elaborate or enlarge upon this successful mechanism. Make it easier, quicker, sure. Allow it to solve more of the problem. Overcome old limitations. Promise extra beliefs. You are beginning a stage of embellishment similar to the second stage of sophistication. And now the final and last level, 5, the market is at maximum skepticism. They no longer believe in mechanisms and something really advanced needs to be activated. This is when all the stops must come out. In the words of Eugene Schwartz, the emphasis shifts from the promise and the mechanism which accomplishes it to identification with the prospect himself. You are dealing here with the problem of bringing your prospect into your ad, not through desire, but through identification. So now that we've gone over all of the five levels of market sophistication, what does this mean for you? So now it's time for you to identify what stage your market is at, so that you can then take that information and really tailor and craft your offer specifically to what those people are looking for. And one quick note here is that we do realize that many of you already have existing offers that you're simply just looking to bring over onto YouTube. And congratulations, you're definitely in the right place, because one of the biggest things to remember and something that will set you miles apart from the competition is that you can't just simply take an already successful ad and plunk it into YouTube and expect it to work. You need to make some changes to have it be successful on YouTube. So definitely keep listening to this video and any of our other tips, because that is how you're really going to make your offer really, really successful on YouTube. So just take a look at your market and determine what level of sophistication they are at. So if your market's at a level one, you know that your message can be pretty simple and you'll be able to just focus right on scaling. However, if your market is at maybe a three or a four, you know that your message is going to require a little bit more work. It's going to need to be more specific. You need to identify your unique mechanism and really make sure that you're nailing that messaging, because your market is simply more sophisticated. And then knowing what level of market sophistication you're at, this will also influence your ad copywriting. So depending on how sophisticated they are, this will also dictate how proactive you need to be about addressing existing objections in your market. And this will also help you share your levers depending on what other options are available among your competition. Tip: a good method to be able to identify and confirm which market level you're at is to check Facebook groups. You can read through the posts and go through the comments, and this should give you some really good insights to really know which market level you are working in. Okay, so now while still on the topic of messaging, we're going to move on to sort of the second major puzzle piece, and that is funnel congruence. And funnel congruence is making sure that your messaging is consistent across your ad, landing page, and webinar. This may seem quite simple and obvious, because it kind of is, but you would be very surprised to see how many people really miss the mark on this one. I want to emphasize the importance of just making sure that it all flows together. Your message should be simple and succinct enough that it can be easily summarized into one or two sentences and then repeated over and over and over throughout your entire funnel. Let's quickly look at links as an example. So the messaging here is, hey, you are looking to get started with YouTube ads and you're too busy to do it and you want to do it fast. So let an experienced YouTube ads agency handle it for you. That's literally it. Nice and simple. Now you understand all the important information and methods you need for messaging research. So what are you waiting for? Get out there and craft your perfect message so that you can start crushing it with your ads. But actually, wait. Before all of the brainstorming and researching magic begins, just take 2 seconds and give this video a big thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and subscribe to the channel. All right, now get to it. Thanks for watching. Bye.